Good morning. My name is Rick DeLaurier. I'm the special agent in charge at the FBI's Boston Division. I would like to start this morning by thanking the first responders from Boston EMS and Boston Fire Department and the volunteer physicians, nurses, and medical staff from the community who volunteered at the marathon. Their services and heroic actions saved lives yesterday afternoon. We continue to work shoulder to shoulder with our JTTF partners at the Boston Police Department, the Massachusetts State Police, as well as all our other JTTF agencies. Our mission is clear: to bring to justice those responsible for the marathon bombing. The American public wants answers. The citizens of the city of Boston and the Commonwealth of Massachusetts want and deserve answers. This group of dedicated men and women standing before you today pledge to do everything possible to get those answers. This remains a very active investigation. Our ongoing investigation in various locations throughout the area goes on. However, there are no known additional threats. We continue to interview various witnesses and process the crime scene, which could take some time. The citizens of Massachusetts and the city of Boston should expect to see the FBI and its JTTF partners conducting investigative activity in the greater eastern Massachusetts and Boston area. Assistance from the public remains critical in establishing a timeline of events which leads to swift conclusion through due diligence and strong investigative activity. We commend the public, we commend the citizens of Boston and the citizens of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts for the information that has been provided to law enforcement so far, and we strongly encourage that assistance to continue. It is paramount to explain the FBI and our JTTF role to a greater extent, the volume of tips we have received, and reiterating the resources we provide. We have received voluminous tips over the last 18 hours since the incident. We have staffed our 1-800 call FBI tip line, and we continue to encourage individuals to contact that line with any additional tips. We are bringing additional victim assistance and evidence response team resources from our headquarters components and other field offices to Boston, and they are on site working as we speak, processing evidence at the crime scene. To the extent that the crime scene still plays in Copley perimeter and it continues to be a crime scene, it may be that for several days. The FBI JTTF is logically following up on a variety of leads. You will see us and our law enforcement partners interviewing, maybe your neighbor or coworker, or even yourself in coming days. We encourage you to please cooperate with law enforcement authorities. The resources the FBI and the JTTF allow for swift action, which we hope will yield quick results, but that does not diminish our diligence and persistence in combing through the high volume of evidence and leads that we are processing right now. We are just beginning upon that path. Thank you very much.
I'm Gene Marquez, Acting Special Agent in Charge, ATF Boston Field Division. At this time, ATF has done a partial NRT, National Response Team activation. We are bringing our explosive specialist here to the scene, and we will be working jointly with the FBI and its partners on the JTTF. We have certified explosive specialists. We have explosives enforcement officers, we have special agent bomb techs, and we have canines that are trained to detect any explosive devices or any residue. At this time, we have approximately 30 forensic specialists en route or on the scene. And to dispel any rumors, there were rumors floating around that there were seven devices at one point. That is not true. I think that happened as a result of some suspect packages that were disrupted, but we only have two devices that we're aware of, and both of those devices were the ones that involved in the damage and were involved in the explosives incident. At this time, we are looking for the public's cooperation. We're looking if there's any video, any photographic evidence. If you can please contact the FBI hotline or the city's hotline, we'd like to review any kind of media that you have out there pertaining that might give us additional investigative leads, and we are pursuing those investigative leads at this time. The scene is going to take several days to process. We just ask for your patience as we're working in that area and for your cooperation.
Good morning. I'm United States Attorney Carmen Ortiz. First, I want to extend my condolences to the families of the loved ones who were lost in yesterday's attack on the city of Boston, as well as those that were hurt and may still be fighting for their lives. Our thoughts and our prayers go out to them. What happened yesterday was a terrible tragedy, yet it was amazing to see, as you have heard from my colleagues here, how people just helped one another, ran toward the blast just to assist another person in greater need. People who were just there for those that were hurt and in a dire situation. It was amazing to see how the city of Boston, the people, and people from around the world that were part of yesterday's Boston Marathon helped one another, consoled each other. There are so many moving parts to an investigation such as this, and I can't begin to thank everyone who has been involved. Law enforcement, medical professionals, emergency responders, and really just regular citizens who became heroes yesterday. I want to repeat, as I did state it yesterday, this is an active and it's an ongoing investigation. But rest assured that we are bringing all of the necessary resources to assist in this matter, and that we will conduct all that we can with all of our law enforcement partners. I've been in touch with the Attorney General several times, Eric Holder, and he has pledged all of the resources from the department and others on behalf of the federal government to help Boston recover from yesterday. I ask for your patience and your understanding as we continue to pursue leads, to gather evidence, and to get to the bottom of who did this and why. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Ed Davis. I'm a police commissioner for the city of Boston. We are in the process of securing and processing the most complex crime scene that we've dealt with in the history of our department. We are doing that under the direction of the FBI and in partnership with the ATF. We've secured the perimeter with members of the National Guard, and the general is here. I'd like to thank the people who are working closely with us. We've received offers of assistance from Chicago, Los Angeles. Units have responded here from New York City and Baltimore, and we are working very closely with all of our partners on this complex investigation. I want to stress that the area around the crime scene, which was yesterday was 15 blocks, has been reduced to about 12 blocks at this point in time. And we will continue to collapse that crime scene as the facts and circumstances make that available. We want to open up as many streets and get people into their buildings as quickly as we can. We're working diligently on that. But please be patient with us in the time that we need to process the crime scene. We expect that that scene will go for another 2 days anyway, and people should make appropriate plans. Again, I want to stress that any information that you have, any videos or photographs that happen, not just at that scene, but anywhere in the immediate vicinity, could be helpful to this investigation. Our focus is on processing that evidence right now, and we're looking forward to working with our partners to bring the individuals who are responsible for this heinous crime to justice. Thank you.
Thank you. Hey,
good morning. My name is Timothy Albin. I'm the superintendent of the Massachusetts State Police. As I said earlier in one of our briefings, there's really two or three parts to this investigation. There's the investigative part, which clearly the FBI has taken the lead on, but there's also a logistical and presence component of this. So I'm speaking to the public. You are going to see an enhanced presence from the Boston Police, from the State Police, from the National Guard, and from our law enforcement partners through the metropolitan Boston area over the next days and probably longer. That's not for any particular reason other than to provide some comfort and to the public who are using transportation centers or going about their business. So we are engaged with the MBTA Police.
Good morning. My name is Daniel Conley. I'm the district attorney here in Boston. What occurred yesterday in Boston was an act of cowardice. While there will be an opportunity in the future at the conclusion of this investigation to officially define this act, make no mistake, an act of cowardice and of this severity cannot be justified or explained. It can only be answered. To that end, some of the finest investigators at the local, state, and federal levels have been working through the night to not only conduct interviews and process the scene, but to ensure that those interviews are legally sound and that the evidence is recovered with the greatest care. At the same time, police and other law enforcement agencies have been actively working to ensure the safety of our city. At this point, the loss that we have suffered is enormous, but thanks to the efforts of EMTs, police officers, firefighters, volunteers, ordinary citizens, and of course, doctors, nurses, and the medical staff at Boston's world-class hospitals, we can say with absolute certainty that more lives were saved. For this, we can all give thanks. In the days and the weeks to come, we will do our very best to keep the public and the media apprised and advised of the progress of this investigation and our work. It is important, however, for the sake of the victims and of this city, that our investigators be given the room to do their jobs so that the truth can be found and so that justice can be served. Moments like this and our response to them define who we are. In the past 24 hours, this city of Boston has shown its strength, its compassion, and its determination to see justice done.
Thank you, Dan. We're happy to take questions. We will, we're going to try to take as many questions as you have. Maybe we'll just go from side to side, if that's, yeah. Well, more than the evidence is the extraordinary cooperation among these law enforcement agencies, as the mayor and others have said, at the federal, state, and local level, and indeed from the region. We have an unprecedented level of law enforcement support and engagement here, and they are working very, very well and very seamlessly with each other under the leadership of the FBI. And that gives me a lot of comfort. It should give the public comfort as well. Over here. Yeah. I think I know what you're getting at. Let me turn it over to Rick, who I think is going to not comment.
Thank you, Governor. I can't comment on that aspect of that. What I think is important to say, what I would like to, on behalf of the Boston JTTF here today, is say that there is no known imminent physical threat at any location where we are conducting and might be conducting investigative activity right now. I want to put that out to the American public, to the citizens of the city of Boston and the Commonwealth of Massachusetts.
Can you tell us, first of all, can you tell us anything about the nature of the devices? And secondly, can you comment on the fact that they've been sweeping the area? And how is it that two devices this powerful polluted this?
I'm not going to be able to comment on that, on the nature of the device right now.
Can you confirm now, Suleiman Ali and also Mohammed Hassan Zada, are they in custody right now or under guard at the local hospital?
No, I'm not going to say who might or might not be in custody right now.
Can you confirm that ICE took one person from Ocean Avenue who is under custody and is looking to respond a second person who is a roommate in that unit?
David, what I can say is ICE is a key component of our Boston Joint Terrorism Task Force. They are active with us right now and are interviewing witnesses with us and assisting us integrally with this investigation. Well, we are processing a lot of digital photographic evidence right now. As several speakers have said today, including the governor, we encourage the continued submission of any photographic evidence that could lead to lead value. But I can't can't comment on the on specific tips or leads right now. And Karen, I think Commissioner Davis can probably speak best about surveillance cameras in the area. Again, I think we're processing all the digital photographic evidence that we possibly can right now as quickly as possible with resources from FBI headquarters and Quantico, and that is a priority of the investigation right now. But I'd let Commissioner Davis speak about the video cameras.
Thank you, Rick. It's a basic investigative protocol at this point in time for us to secure all the video that's in the area. So even as we were removing victims yesterday, officers were assigned to go into the local establishments and secure those videos. There are a large number of them. So there's a logistics issue right now. We are working with the FBI. They're sending special teams to process that information. It's our intention to go through every frame of every...